and works passionately and tirelessly every day. Every new show is the first show for Gordon.
All right, and Gordon's going to be in our ear saying, all right, talk about the main event, which we will do. And it's Vladimir Shishkin and Ulysses Sierra. These are super middleweights. They're going 10 rounds. Shishkin of Russia, Sierra from San Diego. Well, he's almost 31 years of age, Ulysses Sicario Sierra, a seven-year pro. He's been something of a part-time fighter for the latter part of his career. He had just one fight, both in 2015 and 2016. Then he fought twice each in 2017 and 2018, and only one time last year. He fights tonight for the first time in 9 months. But that said, he is 15-0 with two draws. Sierra has stayed busy as a sparring partner, working with Sergey Kovalev for the third time as Kovalev prepared for his fight with Canelo Alvarez. He's also sparred with Andre Ward in the past. As he puts it, I've been in there with the champions. He won a 10-round decision against hometown favorite Fidel Hernandez in his most recent fight. That was last April. He had a couple of draws early in his career, but he's been perfect in the ring since 2014. Sierra seems to prefer working on the inside. He expects Shishkin to be the aggressor in this fight and to throw a lot of punches. His plan is to use Shishkin's aggression against him and walk him into something meaningful. So, Steve, let's go behind the numbers with Ulysses Sierra.
Well, there's no doubt about it. This is a monumental jump for Sierra. In 17 bouts, Barry, Sierra's faced only three fighters with winning records. At the advanced age of 30, he's making a long jumper's leap in quality of opposition. Good and bad. The good news, his most recent fight, Sierra went 10 rounds for the first time. The bad news, that was his only fight in 2019. Then again, Shishkin fought only once last year as well. An ideal preparation, not. Four of Sierra's five most recent fights have been scheduled six rounders in Mexico. Now he faces one of the best super middleweight prospects in boxing. Is he up to it?
We're gonna find out. And this will be our second look at 28-year-old Vladimir Shishkin. We saw him here on Showbox in his American debut. That was in August against DeAndre Ware, who had previously had some impressive outings on this series. Shishkin just didn't stop throwing punches right from the opening bell. The fight was finally stopped by Ware's corner. That was in the eighth round. He turned pro 3 years ago after a long and impressive amateur career. Consisted of 330 fights, and he won 301 of them. Like Ergashev, who we saw earlier, Shishkin has been training with Sugar Hill Stewart in Detroit. He is well-schooled, he's strong, still something of a work in progress, developing more of a pro style, setting down on his punches a little bit more while keeping his volume of punches up. He says, I want to leave a mark on boxing. Tonight, he said, he'll settle for leaving a mark on Ulysses Sierra. Steve, let's go behind the numbers.
I like the yellow crunch shirt, but not with yellow trunks. We start with used to it. The fact that Shishkin has already fought once in America on Showbox last August figures to help him out this time. He says it will. It might be time. About 2 years ago, Shishkin began picking up the quality of his opposition. He's 28 now and seems to be closing in on a spot in the 168-pound top 10. And stopping him. Since elevating the quality of his opponents, Shishkin scored stoppages in four of his last five fights. That's a very good sign.
All right, I say we get on with it then. We go to the center of the ring once more from here in Sloan, Iowa. Vladimir Shishkin versus Ulysses Sierra. Undefeated super middleweights were scheduled for 10 rounds. Here once again is our ring announcer, Thomas Treiber. Thomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our featured bout. It is scheduled for 10 rounds in the super middleweight division. Brought to you by Salida Promotions in association with Patrick Ortiz's Ringside Ticket and Showtime, along with their great sponsors, Gorilla Energy Drink and Buka Boxing. It is sanctioned by the Winnebago Tribal Athletic Commission, Commissioners Gene Gilpin and Alfred Lopez, Acting Director Joe Walsh. Our three judges scoring on a 10-point must system will be Mikey Walsh, Steve Weisfeld, and Barry Wolf, our referee in charge. Third man in the ring will be Adam Pollock. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the time has arrived. Live from the Winnevegas Casino Resort here in Sloan, Iowa, this is our Showbox main event of the evening. Introducing to you first, fighting tonight out of the blue corner. He's wearing blue with silver and weighed in at 167 pounds. Coming to us from San Diego, California, he brings an undefeated record of 15 wins, 2 draws. 9 of his 15 wins come by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ulises Sicario Sierra. And his opponent across the ring in this main event, fighting tonight out of the red corner. He's wearing gold with red and blue and weighed in at 167 and a half pounds. Hailing from Serpukhov, Russia, he is now fighting out of Detroit, Michigan, and representing Kronk Gym. His record, undefeated with 9 wins. 6 of his 9 wins come by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Vladimir Shishkin.
Gentlemen, this is scheduled for 10 rounds. Protect yourselves at all times. Obey my commands. Touch gloves. Fight at the bell.
The numbers here are very similar. At least the dimensions of these two are similar. But look at the ages. Sierra older, but he's the one making a dramatic jump up in quality of opposition. And rule same as our first two fights, no standing eight, no 3 knockdown. Only the ref can stop the fight. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. And the fight becomes official after 4 rounds.
We are scheduled for 10. And here we go, round 1. Shishkin in the gold, Sierra in the blue. You know, before we go too far, too, I want to mention, it is the weather outside, as the old song goes, is just awful. And this crowd, it started out when we got in the building here, there was maybe 100 people here, and it somehow filled up. And I got to tell you, the only way to get to this place is by sled dog.
You know? It's amazing we got here at all.
I still don't know how I got all those Huskies
Raul,
and carry
Raul wanted
bag.
To stay in his room.
But it really is a credit to the people here in Sloan, Iowa for getting here, because it is absolutely brutal.
Yeah, props to the fans here for getting here. I mean, it's unbelievable weather. And you know, you guys know I can't do it.
I know that.
The amateur numbers, Shishkin, 330 amateur fights, mostly at 178 pounds, interestingly, and mostly national level. Sierra, 33 fights, very low total, but he did fight in national. And pro experience, you see Shishkin, only 9 fights, almost as many rounds as Sierra, who's been inactive, a pro since June 2012.
And we'll see, we told you he sparred with some very good fighters, but you know, there's that old thing about a sparring partner's mentality.
Yeah, well, yesterday when we asked him about it, he said, I'm not a sparring partner.
Well, we'll find out as the fight evolves. We'll be able to tell he does have that mentality.
He has found a little bit of a home for that right hand. Good body shot from Shishkin. It's a slapping right hand from Shishkin.
Shishkin very animated as he comes in.
Yeah, he fights a fast pace. I mean, it's just the first round, but he's going to... Trust me, he's gonna start throwing a lot more punches as the fight goes.
Yeah, I did that last time we saw him too.
Yeah.
And when you have 330 amateur fights, especially at a high level, you learn something.
And I think one of the things you learn to do, and Raul can speak for this because he was such a great amateur, you learn to adjust because you don't know who you're fighting. You don't know what kind of style, your size, or anything else.
Every day in a tournament, whether it's a national tournament or a big world tournament, you're dealing with different styles, different speeds, strong guys, weaker guys, more power, less power.
happens.
And that's why we can talk about this guy even after 9 fights, you know, as being close to taking that step from prospect to contender.
One thing, okay? You keep going this way. And that, remember? Then more. See? Bang, bang, bang. Because you keep going net.
And remember, you need to start pressing him when you're on defense. He's getting too comfortable, right? You got me? You feel it? You feel it? The power's good? Everything's good? Okay. Don't throw that right hand from the giggle. Don't force nothing, okay? Be smart. Take your time. Come on.
Here's what Ulysses Sierra told us he needed to do to win this fight.
His biggest weakness, he's there to be hit. From watching his fights, he has leaks in his defense. And if I land with full power, I'm pretty sure I'd get him out of there.
And he actually did get there with a couple of right hands. I don't know that it was enough to win the round, but he got there.
Close round.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah. CompuBox numbers tell us 14 to 12, Shishkin outlanded Sierra.
Sierra's starting to cover up a lot instead of throwing punches.
He had success in the first round with a short right hand. Shishkin double right hand.
Keep him up.
A little bit low there from Sierra. You know, when you see bantamweights, as we did in our first fight, in a small ring, it's not that big a deal. But when you see 168 pounders in a small ring, the ring will really look small.
It makes them look big, too. Yeah. Good sharp right hand from Shishkin.
Very fast to close the distance, Shishkin.
Go holding. Let him go.
Good steady jab. Sierra calls himself the Deontay Wilder of the 168 pounds.
Wow.
And he says if he lands the right hand, you're going to go down. But he has to land the right hand.
He does.
And he's weighing too much with that right hand.
Well, I thought he had a little bit of early success with it in the first round, but in this round, not much.
And there's only one Deontay Wilder.
That's right.
No one can do what he does with one punch.
There's a good right hand right there.
No holding. Let him go. Work out. Let him go. Break. Stop. Stop.
What's the holding?
Box.
Sierra does not in any way seem awed by Shishkin.
No, I think he did his homework. He's trying to take away the jab.
But every time Shishkin gets inside and he's throwing his combinations, he can't allow Sierra to just hold him, because if he does that, it's going to be like that for 10 rounds.
This round, at least, Shishkin more effective with the lead right hand over the jab.
Yes.
That right hand again from Sierra.
One thing Shishkin's doing is putting a lot on every punch.
Stop.
You might want to mix it up a little bit.
Yeah, that's been his problem. That's what Sugar Hill said they've been working on. Try not to load up too much in his shots. Same thing with Ergasov.
Right.
Same thing he works with Ergasov. Yeah.
I know. I understand. But Vladimir, it's here. It's here. You just here. You know, it's boom. You keep throwing. Not. Karochi. Bang. Bang, bang. Throw it. Lock the foot. Boom. Bang. Okay?
It should be said there is a language issue here in this corner because Boom, it's here. Russian is, he says it's improving, it's still not conversational. And Shishkin on the other
hand. Hey, one thing important. What is this?
No.
No, hands up. Net umne. It's net umne. Hands up.
This is only their second fight together.
This is round three. We're scheduled for 10.
We heard Sugar Hill tell Shishkin he wants the right hand straighter. And in the other corner, Sierra, they want him to try to back up Shishkin.
Watch your heads, work out.
I don't feel Shishkin can fight backing up, which could be true. We don't know that. We haven't seen about that.
Body by Shishkin, and he brings it upstairs. And yeah. Straight right hand.
Watch your head.
Good range there. Good, you know, he's mixing it up now.
Yeah. Keep him up. Hey, keep him up.
And you see Sierra listening to his corner, walking to Shishkin.
I think that's what he has to do. He can't fight him from at a distance.
Keep him up.
See, every time he gets close, he's successful hitting him. Look, right there, look. He's pressing him. But then he backs up.
Each got there with the right hand. Double jab from Shishkin. Right hand.
We talked about Shishkin's jab and how good it was the first time we saw him against DeAndre Ware. Look at this. This is shocking. Shishkin clearly being out jabbed both in volume and in connect by Sierra.
Head-to-head. You would think that's where Sierra wants this, but not able to do any business in there.
Keep him up.
Well, Sierra started the round back in Shishkin, but he's not finishing him.
He's weighing too much. Talking about Sierra, laying on the ropes, covering up.
There's that right hand.
It's pretty simple. Every time he lets his shots go, he's successful.
Yeah, especially with that short right hand. That's been good for him. But he's allowing Shishkin out working.
If you like Shishkin in these rounds, it's based on volume function, not any hurting he's doing.
Right. Shishkin almost timed Sierra stepping in that time.
Sierra can't afford a lunge, man. He's got to get a little bit close. He throws the right hand, he falls in. And Shishkin is there to counter him.
Craig, step back. Let him go. Let him go. Step back.
Well, Sierra, it seems, is letting Shishkin out working. That's the story of the fight so far.
Lift up your head. Sit back. Let me the mouthpiece. Don't just get away from you. You're not busy enough. Okay? I understand. But if you let him walk forward, he's going to throw all he wants. You got to make him back up. You see, I need that stick. I need you to throw with speed, not with leaning forward, not falling forward. Okay? You got me? So, let's go, my love. Let's go. You can get this, man. You can let it get... Yeah, man. Impose your will, dog. It's just what you want. Come on, man.
When you go forward, when you step to the ground, you can't... It's like you can't do nothing. As soon as you back up...
He's comfortable, dog. Okay?
Water, then.
Let me agua. Agua, agua, agua. There you go. Come on, son. Dig deep, son. Come on. Drink it.
Coming to round four, scheduled for 10. Shishkin in the gold, Sierra in the blue trunks. This is our main event.
Interesting that Joe Vargas told Sierra, you're letting them out working, work you, but in fact, according to Showbox show stats, they threw about the same number of punches last round. Is Shishkin right hand happy or is it me?
Throwing a lot of them, yeah. That was a good left hand from Sierra.
Shishkin 2-1 on my card. I did give Sierra that first round. I thought it was close, but I just thought he landed the better shots. Shishkin's volume, a little bit, those short right hands have given him the advantage since that first round.
I got Shishkin winning all three rounds. I just think he's outpointing him.
I do too.
And they're right. Shishkin does not like going backwards. I mean, that, he don't prefer going backwards. See? They're 1-2.
Yeah.
Let him go. Work out.
Yeah, Sierra's had his moments.
But then he holds and then he backs up. I mean, is that sparring?
Break that back.
Sparring partner mentality? I mean, throw a couple of shots and then step back. Oh, he's backing up.
Catching a lot of Shishkin's punches in the gloves.
Or the arms.
Shishkin missed everything.
Keep
sequence.
At this point, Shishkin's using that jab only to set up the right hand. It's not a weapon on its own as it was against the DeAndre Ware. Matter of fact, he's missing with the jab a lot.
Yeah, actually, I think he's getting
breakout
in this round. At least outscored, if not outworked. Couple good body shots from Shishkin, and now a right uppercut. That's what Sierra's corner wants from him. Walk him down and hit him with the right hand.
And when Sierra's trying to come forward like this, you would think that that would give Shishkin the opportunity to land more jabs to stop that forward progress. He's not doing it.
No, you're right.
Let him go. Work out. Work out. No holding. Bring your hands back and punch. Work out.
I thought a much better round for Sierra.
I agree.
Where's the mouthpiece? Oh, I tell her. Really good work. I need the same thing, okay? Same thing. I need you to press this, man. Don't take no breaks in the rounds, okay? Do not take any breaks in the rounds. You're going to take a break. You're going to take a break. Listen to me. You're going to take a break walking forward, okay? If you don't want to let your hands go so much, walk with your hands up. Defense. Make this man backpedal. The only time he has success is when he's walking forward.
See, when you're in the middle, You guys are right here.
Yeah, your knees are too locked up.
And come up with something.
I need that body shot once in a while, man. Okay? Solar plex, left hook to the body, okay? Stay a little busy with your 1-2. You'll get this man out. Make him fight. Make him fight. Come on, baby. That's what you've been working all your life for. Come on. Almost those rounds up.
This is round 5, and it's been a more competitive fight, I think, than a lot of people might have thought.
Keep him up.
Well, it's being fought in a way I didn't anticipate, that's for sure. Yeah, we didn't see a lot of tape on Sierra. His rep is more as a sparring partner. And he obviously has to have something going for him to spar regularly with Kovalev and Canelo. And
let him go. Work out.
Andre Ward as well.
Obviously, I mean, right. four camps right, with Kovalev. 3 with Canelo, 1 with Ward. That's a lot of learning. That's a lot of experience. And maybe that's why he's still here.
Stop.
Shishkin.
Keep your head up and don't hit him low.
Even with the headgear and the bigger gloves, you have to be able to take a shot when you're fighting guys like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Sparring.
He told us he learned a lot from Canelo. He's got a lot of tricks. Nice double left hand from Sierra.
Neither of these fighters has ever been down as a pro.
Look at that. They want Sierra to keep pressing, and that's the only way to be successful with Shishkin. They told him not to take any breaks.
Right. And
don't
they
step back.
If,
and
if you do this, and do it coming forward.
Coming forward, exactly. Now he's taking breaks. Now he's backing up. Now, I'm telling you, he's successful at times, but then he backs up.
And Shishkin finally showing a little bit of a consistent jab.
Yeah, that's been a long time coming. 3 jabs right there. It was a right hand that seemed to get Sierra's attention. I don't know.
And Shishkin retaliated. You know, he got that instinct. He came back again with another right hand.
Raul, if Shishkin's going to throw that many right hands, what's the counter punch of choice? What should Sierra be looking to counter with? A hook or a right? What do you think?
I think Sierra's got to counter with a hook, with his right hook. You see right there when Shishkin threw that right hand and he drops it. So then Sierra's going to come back with the left hook, right hand. Right there.
Because he should have the timing down by now, because Shishkin's used that right hand again and again and again. There it is again.
And again. And a combination that puts Sierra into the ropes.
But see, that's what I was talking about Shishkin. When he starts, gets in his rhythm and he starts throwing like a lot of punches, it makes the fighter go into a shell. And that's why Sierra's going into a shell. Yeah.
Exactly what you said.
But he's got to do more of that. Shishkin's got to do more of that. It's round number five. I think as the round goes, he's going to start doing more.
Still goes with the right hand lead. Stop.
This is a scheduled 10 rounder, so we are at the halfway mark. Jabs, surprising that Shishkin has landed only 14 and only 22%. His advantage is power shots. A lot of the right hands he landed have not really been power shots, they've been soft punches, but he's landing 41%. And the body work, interestingly, Shishkin, a lot of those have been right hands to the body.
Here we see Shishkin. I got him ahead, but if he really wants to make a statement, he needs to pick up his punch output, throw more 3 and 4 punch combinations, and push Sierra back, make him go into a defensive shell, and that's when he's gonna get ahead. Now for Sierra, he can't afford to go backwards. He can't afford to take breaks. He's got to push him, start with the jab, and try to land that big Deontay Wilder right hand that he says that he has.
So this is round six, past the halfway point now. Been a more competitive fight than I think many people would have thought.
I totally agree. I'm very surprised, but this is the second half of the fight. Maybe Shishkin is going to start picking up the pace.
Yeah, that
a lot more.
I agree, Raul. I
think Shishkin, that
fifth round was the first round that resembled a little bit Shishkin versus DeAndre Ware.
Yeah. That's a wild right hand.
Hands back. Let him go. Work out.
By the way, Sierra, the son of a former major league pitcher.
That's right.
Only 1 year with the San Diego Padres.
Makes him a major league pitcher.
That's it. I've given Shishkin all the rounds. I think one of you guys might have given the fourth, I think it was, to Sierra.
Yes, I gave the fourth to Sierra.
So did I.
And you guys gave the first to Shishkin.
Yeah,
and
I have the same score. Yeah.
Same total, but we got there in different ways.
Shishkin that time at least showed the jab and it came to the right hand.
I guess you could say Shishkin typically Eastern European in that the right hand is of the power punch, not a left hook. Yeah, I've not seen him throw a lot of left hooks.
Yeah, he just measures you with that jab. It's a good measuring stick. He pops it out there. A lot more busier too in this round.
Yeah, Shishkin. Nice combination.
Look at that.
I get the sense that a little of the starch has gone from Sierra.
There he goes. You see activity, and look what Sierra's doing.
That combination again.
Covering up, going into a shell.
Work out, let him go.
That volume punching that Raul talked about, that's really been the difference.
He needs more, a lot more.
Brings that right hand very quickly behind the jab when he throws the jab. I think Sierra is not the same guy he was earlier.
Definitely agree with you, Barry.
That right hand getting there with more frequency now for Shishkin. Clash of heads there.
If you're going to wait the way Sierra's waiting, you better make your counter punches count. He's really not doing that. Fishkin showing good legs. I can't believe he's 168 pounds. I mean, he's got big legs, big upper body.
Another round for
Shishkin. Good round for Shishkin. Pretty dominant round. Here's a look at Shojo Hoon, Ergashev. What he's looking, you know, he's got a million, count them, a million Instagram followers. And he didn't follow anybody.
A million.
A million, count them. And he's answering each one individually here. That's amazing.
Might take him all night.
And what a night he's had. So I'm sure he's getting nothing but huzzas from his million followers, because listen to what this fight sounded like and how quick it went.
Four, five, six.
It's painful, that's all I can tell you.
Left hook to the liver.
Those Instagram followers enjoyed that. 1 million, did you say?
A million.
Like in a million.
As in a million. He is huge in Uzbekistan. Huge. Not only Uzbekistan, but there's three Uzbekis in Des Moines, Iowa, who were here tonight.
Yes, we heard that story. Yes. Amazing. Because Ergashev was originally, I believe, supposed to be on the Showtime show from a week ago, and he got moved to this show.
That's right.
So those fans from Des Moines were ready to go all the way to Atlantic City, and they ended up having to travel a much shorter route.
Albeit much colder.
Yeah.
Look out, let him go.
And one of the things I'm interested in seeing, and we're not going to probably see it in this fight, is Sugar Hill Stewart wants to turn Shishkin into a complete fighter. And the part of him that needs the most work is the infighting. We're really not seeing much of it in this fight. We didn't see it in the DeAndre Ware fight.
No. He's really good at long to mid-range.
Good holding.
Throw the shots from there, but there's every time he gets an inside, that's the problem.
Watch the holding, you guys.
He's got to bend his legs and become more of a...
Keep him up.
Well, inside fighter by digging to the body and working better up the middle.
And too much
holding in it.
I'm sure he's also going to talk to him about using the jab more. Thought in the last couple of rounds, using a little bit more, but as you pointed out, Steve, early in the fight, hardly at all.
He should occasionally be jabbing to the belly, too, because Sierra holds those gloves pretty high, trying to neutralize that jab. Talk about Sierra being relatively inexperienced. He's been 10 once. Shishkin, fewer fights, but he's been 7 or more 4 times with 3 knockouts. So he has scored some late round knockouts, something you don't always see in prospects.
I think Shishkin is really starting to control this fight.
That right hand was the best punch Sierra's landed in 3 rounds.
Yeah. He's caught on the gloves.
I'm telling you, every time he lets. I think Shishkin is dominating, winning the fight comfortably, but every time Sierra lets some punches go, he's successful, but then he holds back. It's like he holds back.
I think he's getting out quick now also.
And as long as Shishkin allows him to do that, I mean, he's going to go the distance. You know, he can't just lean on him and let Sierra put his body on him and hold. He's got to work off of that. And no punches. That's the only way he's going to get the stoppage. I mean, obviously, that's what we want to see from a guy like Shishkin. After we saw him perform against DeAndre Ware, who he stopped.
He broke him down.
There you go. That's we need more of that.
So, again, a winning round, if not a completely dominant round for Shishkin.
Okay, good.
Vladimir. More pressure.
There you go.
When you're inside, it's here and here. You never throw here. Right here. Yeah, that bang, boom. You know it? Okay. More pressure.
Is that Russian? It almost sounds the same like in Spanish or English.
Yeah.
Or preso. Taking Russian classes.
Speaking of Russian classes, you know, Shishkin spends 2 hours a day learning English.
Yeah. Very bright guy. Very bright guy.
Well, he has a law degree from Russia.
Yeah.
Show stats tell us as this fight progresses, Shishkin throwing more punches per round than he was in the first half of the fight.
I think Sugar Hill wanted to go downstairs, not doing that, but doing enough.
Yeah, right there, he wants him to bend the leg, go to the side of the body, and then go to the solar plexus right in the middle and stay there. Not hold, don't allow Sierra to lean his body on him. Create room, push him back. That's a nice little jab to the body right there. Now go to the body right there.
You know, Shishkin's landing flush, but with that high guard and the elbow so inside, tucked inside by Sierra, this would really be the time to start landing some left hooks, and I just don't know that he has it in his repertoire.
Watch your head. Because
that side, that right side is open for the left hook.
That's a very good point.
Keep it clean.
You see how Sierra puts his elbows almost together when he's covering up.
Well, if Shishkin comes up the middle, too, well, that's a nice one, too. He's got to open up that guard. He's got to find a way.
Shishkin just walking Sierra down. He's being more effective. He's throwing more punches, and he's winning every round.
Head up. Hold it. Work out.
Nice jab right hand. Come right up the middle with that jab. It's not a huge jab, but it's getting there.
Shishkin needs to throw more flurries. A lot of flurries and then power shot. With more flurries, more activity, push it back. He needs to stop his win. I want to see him stop. Sierra.
Break, step back. Step back.
He's winning the fight.
Yeah, he's winning every round.
Yeah.
Come on, Sierra, let's go!
And Sierra reduced to fighting in spurts now.
Yeah.
Showing a little life this round, though.
Yeah, he is. Much more so. Final seconds of round number 8, and it's more of the same.
Break, step back.
Next Saturday night, January 25th, Showtime Championship Boxing, presented by Premier Boxing Champions, brings you a triple header from Brooklyn, New York.
Warning. May I have your attention? At the sound of the bell, any and all punches, including jabs, hooks, and uppercuts will be legal for 12 continuous rounds.
What a flurry by Garcia!
Danny Garcia is back to purge the welterweight division. Plus, Jarrett Hurd returns to strike fear inside the ring. On Showtime.
Let's dig, son. Take this motherfucker out.
Stay back.
This is round 8. I beg your pardon, round 9.
Round 9, huh? All Shishkin. Besides maybe one round.
All Shishkin all the time.
Shishkin 94 punches last round. He was fight high.
There's a right hand and a left behind it. One of the few left-hand power shots he's thrown.
Work your hands free. Work your hands free. Bring your hands back. Stop holding. Work out.
Shishkin has to find a way to get away from it, like clinch. He's allowing Sierra to
Stop.
Take a breather. Take a break.
Keep those punches up.
Well, clearly, for my taste, one of the things Sugar Hill is going to have to work on with Shishkin is that left hook. It just that doesn't exist.
Yeah.
The jab is good. The right hand's been landing all night. And I've had Shishkin winning every round since the first. He's clearly ahead as Barry and Raul, I believe.
Break, Ethel. Break, step back. No wrestling. Watch the wrestling.
But there's work to be done.
Yeah, I think he can be a more complete fighter. You can see his energy level is stupendous.
Very good.
He's got a lot of energy.
And he's still busy enough. Look at him, round number 9. And
keep him up.
Just a little
keep
bit more
up.
Consistent with combinations. And again, that inside work.
Sierra covering up, backs into the corner now.
Yeah, again, it's hard when Sierra doesn't take any risk and he's just covering up, then it's hard to knock a guy out like that. So
yeah, he's not giving him much.
No.
Well, I'll tell you, for a 168-pounder, he throws a lot of punches. This is not Jericho Quinn as a bantamweight or a featherweight. This is a big, much bigger fighter. It's impressive.
Sierra now just covering up. Two right hands. I wonder if Sierra's legs are betraying him a little bit here.
I still believe, guys, that Shishkin has a chance to stop him.
I do too. Yeah,
I really think so. Look, right there.
And I think it's Sierra's legs that have just kind of left him.
Look at that. Barrage of punches. That's what he needs. Push him off.
Break. Step back.
He's dead tired. Sierra's really holding on.
Stop holding. Stop holding.
Feint with the right hand, then he missed with two right hands. Sierra up against the ropes. He's in some trouble here. Good right hand again. I don't think it'll take a lot. Back into the corner at the bell.
Oh. The bell saved him.
Saved by the bell, yeah.
Saved by the bell.
Come on, sit down. Listen to me.
Some water in my head.
Listen to me. You can't give up this fucking fight right now, dog. All right? You've come in a long way to give up right here, man. I need you to dig deep and let your hands go and don't load up, dog. You're making a lot of little simple mistakes that you should better than that.
Hey, Doc, grease right here. A light little cut. I need to grease.
Yep.
Pressure on. Finish him. Good distance. Press him.
Balance. Back toe up. You can't just stand straight.
Come on,
up.
PT.
If you're not going to punch, you can't stand straight up. You got to put your head
come
on,
man. Side. Come on, son. Dig deep. Let's go.
I need this round.
Seconds out.
Let's finish him. Finish him.
Last round. Final round. Last round, okay?
So, Tim Pratt, I'm sure Shishkin would love to close the deal.
I think that's what Sugar Hill Stewart said.
Yeah.
Told him.
Get him out of here.
We should point out, I don't know if you've mentioned this, Barry, maybe you did, but Sugar Hill Stewart now training Tyson Fury. That's a tremendous opportunity for him.
Shishkin said he wants to go to Las Vegas and just be a part of things there. And again, Sierra backing up. And once again, I don't believe it would take a lot to get Sierra out of here.
Keep him up. Keep him up.
Low blow from Sierra.
It's got to be discouraging and tiring to know that your opponent's going to throw punches for 3 minutes every round.
Yeah.
That's what Shishkin's doing.
Step back.
Even in round 10.
Great conditioning.
Yeah, he's still got a lot left, I think. Sierra just trying to suck it up here.
Sierra's fighting a pure heart and just trying to survive and cover up. That's all he's doing. Throw every down, one and two, one, two.
Shut up. Watch your head.
Dead tired.
Yeah. We really saw the volume punching of Shishkin on the second half of the fight. Not so much the first one.
There we go.
Four punch combination. Once again, he's up on top of him. The left hand pushes him back, and Sierra trying to tie him up, and finally does.
A little bit too tight. Just got to loosen up. It's easily said, But he has been working 10 hard rounds, talking about Shishkin.
Nice uppercut there from Shishkin. Right hand a little short. Still, 1:10 remaining. He was short with that right hand.
Let's go.
hand again, but Sierra right there.
Shinsuke's loaded up now with the shots.
Yeah. Well, he knows.
Yeah.
It would not take a lot.
I just don't think one shot's going to do it. He's got to do it with more activity.
Right.
Flourish and then the big bomb.
Sierra throws a couple of shots.
And I hate to beat a dead horse, but if he threw a left hook once in a while, in his combination.
No, that's right. Absolutely right.
Right there.
He uses a straight left, but no left hook.
25 seconds left.
I break that back.
It appears that Sierra may survive here. Another combination from Shishkin. Sierra will take one more lap. Final 10 seconds of the fight. And Sierra's going to survive this. That's over. I don't think the decision is much in doubt.
It's a good experience for Shishkin because I know he's going to go back and look at this fight and says, man, I could have stopped this guy. You know when you get in the bag and you do speed drills, just pass for 15 seconds, 30 seconds speed drills, straight punches, combinations. That's what he needed to do to stop.
Shushan.
Yeah. Exactly. You know about Shushan?
You know about Shushan. My shoes are shining.
Yeah.
Exactly. Shushan.
Well, I think my impression of Shishkin is that what he did well tonight, we already knew that he does well. But I think some weaknesses are apparent. And again, as I said at the top, more work with Sugar Hill Stewart, an American trainer, teach him a left hook. There's one thing we know about Kronk fighters, they usually can punch.
That's right. That's right.
They're taught the punch that goes back to Emmanuel Stewart's days, Sugar Hill Stewart's uncle.
Well, you know, I think it's easy to look at that long amateur career, but the fact remains, he's now only had 10 fights.
Yeah. It is a different game.
I understand.
But you like his volume. He's in fantastic shape. He appears to have a jab that is pretty good.
Yeah.
He seems to underuse it a little bit.
Well, in the second half of the fight, I think we saw it much more so than in the first half. First half, at one point, I almost asked you guys if you thought there was something wrong with his left hand because he wasn't using it at all.
And I think your point about a left hook is, and I don't think that's going to not be seen by Sugar Hill. So it's still a learning procedure, and he remains undefeated. I think exactly what you said is precisely spot on, and that is that he's shown us that he's in great shape, and here you got a good example of it.
Yeah, this was his opportunity to finish the fight, as Raul thought he should have done. And the jab, again, setting up the right hand, but again, jab. There's a left hook, nothing on it, though. And he used the second left hook more to position Sierra than to hurt him. Numbers, well, the jab totals for Shishkin because of the second half of the fight increased dramatically. He landed more of the power shots, threw more power shots, and 36% respectable total. Not busy enough for Sierra, obviously. And good body work by Shishkin, most of them right hands to the body. So statistically and on our cards, he did what he had to do.
All right, let's see how the judges saw this one. We go once again. Thomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Steve Weisfeld scores it 100-90, and both judges Mikey Walsh and Barry Wolf score it the same, 99-91, all in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Vladimir Shishkin!
So,